Lock on lock.
I made about a million and I'm only 19. I see water dripping on a white tee. And shorty got a man, but she saying wife me. I got chest coming in like a pair of Nikes. If I like it, then you know I'm finna get it. Hit the bag and then I flip it, watch me do it. All them all on my wrist going stupid. Tryna put them on, but they never do it. They like, hold up, wait a minute, like don't make sense to really get it. I'm steady getting to the chicken, that tasty finger licking chicken. I mean, I'm getting to the good guap. Keep a rack in my socks. Diamonds cost me a lot. Nike check up all of my socks. Hey, hey yo. Nike check.
First opened back in 1975. There's a look inside the iconic Mercedes-Benz Superdome in downtown New Orleans. This is what it looked like just a moment ago in the heart of New Orleans. Folks, there's no place for this noise to go in the Superdome. It is loud, and these fans are ready for football as their Saints get ready to do battle with the San Francisco 49ers. The veteran kicker, Robbie Gould, set to get us started, and we are underway from the Superdome. Fielded in the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
Over at first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Breeze now to throw. This is complete to Michael Thomas. He'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of 7.
Michael Thomas.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
A first carry now. This is Alvin Kamara. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. 4 yards the pickup, first down. For these two teams, the Saints and Niners, they played maybe the game of the year in the NFL in 2019, had 94 points between them. Lead changes left and right. Breeze had 5 touchdowns, 4 for Garoppolo, and you might remember the catch and stiff-arming run by George Kittle where he just refused to go down. And then in the end, it was Robbie Gould who kicked the field goal as time expired, and the Niners would win it 48-46. So the big play has them all the way down to the 30 now for first and 10. Breeze leaves this one with Kamara. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage.
No gain.
Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Shotgun now for Breeze. Gets this to a standout receiver, Thomas. And he'll be out of bounds, able to get it down to the 25 there. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. From the gun, it's Breeze. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
Come on, one thing for sure, you know that Michael Thomas is going to be the target on a third down pass, and Drew Brees finds him and keeps his drive moving.
And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the 2.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. It makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
Now with just 1 second showing on the play clock, we're going to get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. On second and goal. Touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Saints take it right down the field and score on the opening drive. Looks good on the extra point. And that makes the score 7-0. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. And a fair catch signal for and taken successfully.
5 yard line. The Niners take over first and 10. At their own 25-yard line.
Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. There's Garoppolo to throw. He'll have a first down past the 40. He's got this to the rookie from ASU, Brandon Ayuk. Good yardage after the catch. Is that play good for 30 and a first? That's evidence of why you spend a high draft pick on a receiver, isn't it, Charles?
It certainly is. His ability to make plays like that, and we've seen flashes of it from him so far in his rookie season. But also, it opens things up for the rest of the offense because they have to bring their attention to him as well.
Garoppolo on first down. Flushed out right. He's going to fire one. Corner of the end zone. And this is intercepted, but they'll say out of bounds. Oh, very close to a turnover there in the end zone. He was looking for the rookie, Brandon Ayuk. And it's second down. From the gun, it's Garoppolo. The first catch of the game for George Kittle. And he'll go out of bounds right around the 40. 5 yards, now it's third and 5.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
Garoppolo again. Open man is Ayuk, complete. Garoppolo to Ayuk, first down 49ers.
When you're a player of his stature, you don't just circle the games on your team's calendar. You
circle the Pro Bowl?
Without a doubt. That's a game that you just figure you're going to be in each and every year. That's because of catches like that. That's why he goes.
There's Garoppolo on first and 10. In coverage and it's intercepted. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line. The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started.
And you know, it's certainly a lot of football left to play. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're in first place in their division, looking really good and looking to be a threat come January.
And are you one of those early holiday shoppers, partner? Are you one of those guys, get your list done? Because I think about what every team has on their holiday shopping list right now. What's the number one goal? Make the playoffs. Number two, win your division.
And the Niners get there and bring him down. And Nick Bosa so quick on the outside, he gets in there to bring him down. Defensive end gets in there that time. They were in a 4-3. What's the responsibility of the ends versus the tackles there, Charles?
Well, most of the time when you talk about the ends, they're your pass rushers. They're the guys that you turn loose to try and get to the guy who's going to throw the football. The tackles, usually more of the run-stuffing variety. But the way this game is advanced, you're wanting a little bit of everything out of all of your guys. But let's just go ahead and break it down and make it simple. The guy who's a right defensive end versus a right-handed quarterback, that's the blind side. He's going after the quarterback. He's going to put him on the ground.
Ready for the second quarter from New Orleans. It's the Saints in possession. And they'll come up looking to keep this drive moving. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. good return that time. 18 yards. And the Niners will go on offense. First and 10. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 the score as they start first and 10. Now a breakout star for the Niners in 2019. This is Raheem Mostert. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that'll make this a second and 13. To throw is Garoppolo. That's complete to Mostert out of the backfield. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Throwing on first is Garoppolo, escaping the pressure right. And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. Completes it to the tight end, Kittle. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints' 34-yard line. Give them 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
First down.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Again, they'll throw with Garoppolo. Flush to his right. That's caught by his running back, Raheem Mostert. Touchdown, 49ers! Raheem Mostert, his 11th touchdown of the year. And the 49ers are within an extra point of tying this thing up. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2. Russell all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Turn on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. First with Kamara. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
4 yards, the pickup, first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10 at the 48-yard line. Now they'll throw with Breeze. That's caught inside the 20. Getting this one all the way down inside the 20. That goes for a gain of 31. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Bree's going to throw to the end zone, but it's incomplete. The Pro Bowler Michael Thomas was the intended receiver, and now it's second down. That is the first time that they've targeted him that he has not come down with a catch.
He's caught everything that's been thrown his way, a dominant pass receiver that can break down any defense, because when he's doing that kind of work, it really hurts you on the back end.
And even though it's an incompletion there, I think they're going back to that well. They'll get this one underneath to Kamara. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with 3rd and 1.
Oh, I came to my feet on that one. I thought he was getting close to breaking that one big, but in the end, give some credit to the defense, finding a way to get to him and forcing a 3rd down.
Here's Kamara trying to run for it. And boy, he is very close to a 1st down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker, and what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on 4th and inches. Touchdown nor the 1st down. And the 49ers are going to get the football back. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got to the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
The 13-yard line.
Garoppolo, quick throw out to Ayuk. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up 3rd down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
Looking to throw, Garoppolo. That's complete to his receiver, Ayuk. And he'll go out of bounds finally at the 7. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. The defense, they weren't fooled on that post route. They just couldn't make the play.
And the offense definitely tried to fool them, because you saw the other route combinations, didn't you? Anything that they were running trying to draw attention away from the deep part of the field, but still had it covered. Yet they were able to come up with a nice play.
No gain there on the completion. It'll be 2nd down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown.
San Francisco.
Raheem Mostert, his 2nd touchdown of the game, giving him 12 on the season. And the 49ers have now taken the lead.
Makes the score.
Gold with the extra point, and that makes the score 14-7. After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gold now to kick it away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards.
At their own 21-yard line.
Woo! The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started.
And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this drive?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach, because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot on the field. And he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you've got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you've got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit. They're in the same spot again.
We'll see what the decision is here if they get to that spot. The target that time, Michael Thomas. And it's third and five.
Love the idea, love the concept, but you got to leave a little room on the sideline so he can fade into it when he makes the catch. That was thrown too close to it for the receiver to make a play.
From the gun on third down, Breeze. And going deep for home. These guys have got it back in the closing stages of the first half.
The 49ers. They'll take over first and 10 at their own 42.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Eluding the pressure right. From across his body, and it's intercepted. P.J. Williams with a pick. And his guys have got it back in the closing stages of the first half.
Intercepted. The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 44-yard line.
Good starting field position as they come up here first and 10 at their own 44. The final shot before half for Breeze. He's going to go up top again. In a heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off on a safety, Jarquiski Tartt. Touchdown, that's the difference on the scoreboard. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. It's the 49ers out in front, and they will get the football first as well as we are back and started in the second half. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete. Brandon Ayuk, the one he was looking for. But it'll be second down. Garoppolo going to give to Mostert. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34. The ball
carrier. Kid had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. And for the Saints here on third down, an extra defensive back on the field. Once again, it's Mostert, and he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. It'll be a pickup of only a yard, and it'll result in a fresh set of downs. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Garoppolo now. Flushed out right. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. Brandon Ayuk, the one he was looking for. That'll bring up second down.
As soon as I saw him break contain and get outside, my first thought and my eyes gravitated downfield, because nowadays, most of these quarterbacks, when they do that, they want the big play downfield. They don't want to throw it short. In this case, he took the shot. It fell incomplete.
Escaping the pressure right. And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because they nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game. Instead, they're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
An important play right here, 3rd and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Throwing is Garoppolo on 3rd down. Gonna get this into the hands of Mostert. And a tackle gonna be made at the 41 as they stop him a few yards short of the first. That one good for only 6, and it leaves him with a 4th down. Here comes the 49ers punter now, as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. And this will be out of bounds. Now it's a question of where they'll mark it. And they'll say it crosses at the 11-yard line. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. Their defense just came up with a stop right out of the locker room, and now can the offense take advantage?
Yeah, we don't want to turn this into something that it's not. It's only a one-score game, so it's not exactly a crucial possession. But at the same time, they'd like to get things started and at least come away with 3 points.
Brings up 2nd and 5.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Off the play fake to Kamara. It's Breeze. This is complete to Michael Thomas. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
1st and 10 at the 35-yard line.
On 1st down, Breeze. This one grabbed by A.J. Green. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays.
1st down. 1st and 10 at the 46-yard line.
On 1st and 10, here's Breeze. Flush to his right. He goes full extension, and he's got it. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another 1st down.
I know you don't get anything extra for degree of difficulty, but maybe you should. He's done absolutely everything in this game today, including laying out for that one.
Throwing on 1st down is Breeze. Gets this to a standout receiver, Thomas. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 12 more yards for him there. It's a 1st down.
1st down. 1st and 10 at the 27-yard line.
From the gun, it's a run for Kamara. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Looking to throw on 2nd down. Breeze, got a man, and he hits him in stride. That was play number 7 on this drive, and it got him 7 yards.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
On play action, it's Breeze. 4th down now, San Fran's defense is strong in coverage.
You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
And Lutz puts this one through. And they'll cut the lead back down to 4 now at 14-10. So the drive stalls out inside the 15-yard line, but they do get 3.
And I've talked with enough players nowadays, and when they have these types of kicks, that no one says to their guy, hey, that's just like making an extra point, piece of cake. Because the extra point is not a piece of cake anymore. But kicking a field goal from that distance, just give him confidence and let him knock it through.
Set to get this drive underway. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
And incomplete, he dropped it. Maybe a rookie mistake there. Second down.
I think that was good strategy there, trying to go right back to him after the last completion. But this time, the defense was all over it, and they got there to break that one up.
And he's taken down here by the Saints. David Onyemata able to drop him for a loss of four from his defensive tackle spot.
And it's third.
So the sack of Garoppolo. And now what can they come up with on third and long? From the gun, it's Garoppolo, eluding the pressure right. Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. And that will be incomplete. And they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
And that's a really good job there defensively. They went into this possession knowing that they needed to get a stop. They're in a tight ball game, and they got it done. Great work to force the three and out. Got the football right back for their offense. They've got to go to the sidelines feeling pretty good about themselves and encouraging their offensive mates to get some points.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And last time, able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. On second down and four, Breeze drops this off to Kamara out of the backfield. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. Four-yard pickup leaves him with third and one. That'll be a pickup of four as they work with his four-point fourth-quarter lead. The Saints on third down, just one for five to this point. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. He may try and run for this. He's got the first down and more past midfield. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Give him 18 there, and the Saints have a first down.
10 at the 44-yard line.
They'll run out of the gun with Kamara. And he takes it down to the 40 with a pickup of four.
Number 41.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Shotgun now for Breeze. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And Breeze is intercepted for the third time. Picked by Emmanuel Mosley. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
First and 10 at their own 6-yard line.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Another important fourth quarter series coming up. That last INT helping to maintain their slim advantage. They'll start on the ground with Mostert. They find some open field here. Field right around the 40-yard line. That one good for 33 and a first. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
Well, there you go. Save your best scramble of the day for a big-time situation in the fourth quarter, picking up the first.
You don't want to use it up early, right? Evon, make sure you save it for that exact moment, that key time. And that's what he did, although you and I both know it wasn't planned that way. But what a nice job using his eyes, scanning the field, and realizing when it was time to exit the pocket and go.
Debo Samuel was the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Garoppolo to try again on second down. Open man is Kendrick Bourne. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three.
A gain of 7 yards, and it's third down.
As big of a play as we've had in this one so far. This is third and three.
13.
They'll try and run here with Mostert. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. A gain of 10 and a 49er first down.
It's a gain of 10. First down, San Francisco.
Mostert. Demario Davis makes the tackle. He led the Saints in that category in 2019.
Now the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right, but the problem for them is still within a possession, so they can't just sit on it running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
Now a quick throw as they get it to Ayuk outside. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
First down, 49ers.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. Throwing on first is Garoppolo. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
This has certainly been a physical game so far. Limited scoring opportunities for both sides. And there's another chance that goes unfulfilled.
Back to the running game with Mostert. And he's going to push his way down to about the 12. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Again, they'll run it with Mostert. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up a first and goal. It's first and goal, and a late touchdown at this stage could officially salt this one away. Here's Mostert. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number 2, as he'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's brought down right at the 5-yard line. Give him 2 on the play. Now the Saints will use their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. They'll run with Mostert. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to bring up a fourth and goal.
This is a long drive offensively. Wouldn't you hate to end this with just 3 points?
Doesn't it feel like during a ball game you have certain narratives going on and there's certain drives that seem to take on just a bit more importance than others? This feels like one of those, doesn't it? To me, 3 points here, a major letdown. This is the time to go and put 6 on the board.
And in his 15th season, he's able to get this one to go. And that moves him up by a touchdown now at 17-10. From a defensive perspective, though, I think maybe they're saying, hey, we did what we needed to do, kept this a one-score game.
Yeah, without a doubt, because they were able to bleed some time off the clock, right? Put themselves in a good position, but it's not out of reach yet, okay? Being able to hold them to a field goal means that they do have a chance to come back and win this game.
Takes this about 5 yards deep. Decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. One possession game. Time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be somewhat relaxed. And I know that's counterintuitive because this is a pressure situation. But this is Friday practice every week of the season. You go over this situation, having to go downfield, limited timeouts, getting out of bounds and keep the drive going and set yourself up. Defensively, you can't just lay back and let them do whatever they want. So it is a cat and mouse deal here. How much pressure will the defense bring and how much pressure can the offense handle?
We're going to find out. Second and 10. They'll look to throw. Flushed out right. Worse than the loss of yardage, they also lose the down. So now it's third and long. Back to throw. That's to his running back. It's Alvin Kamara. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45.
First and 10 at the 46-yard line.
The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. One final try here for Breeze. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Safety, Jarquiski Tart. And that is going to seal this victory as time runs out.
Today's final score, 9.
We were on hand for a fun and entertaining game here, coming down really to that last play. Great job defensively to get the pick and seal it.
And we know that every play during a game matters. You're never sure which one's going to be one of the key ones. But at the end of the game, when you analyze it, 3, 4, 5 plays are going to be the ones you focus on. And that last play was one of them. The last shot, had to take it, and they came up with the interception and sealed their victory.
So for the 49ers, it's a win they needed, if for nothing else than their sanity, as they move to 4-6. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week before they get back at it again.
Game over, time's up. Play my cards, dealt my hand, ain't really no time for luck. Either you got it, you don't. Lie to yourself if you won't. I put my team on my back. Did what I could, what I had. Now I'll be all in my bag. Copy and paste with the swag. Bet you can't do it like me. All my winners on repeat. Take your L like a boss. Stand 10 toes on your feet. I can never take a loss. I ain't set up for defeat. 4 Giottos on the truck. I had a dream and it's tough. Living my life cause we up. Looking back like where the love. So I'll be hella low key. But contrary to belief.
loyalty runs deep. I keep my ear to the streets. Struggle turned me to a beast. I'm off the chain, I'm off the leash. But baby girl, I play for keeps. Told my brother lately, I've been scheming. Against all odds like Willie Beeman. I've been grinding lately, this my season. Lord knows I'm trying to find my reason. Lay it out on the line, ain't no looking back. Giving my all with no strings attached. Came from the bottom, rolls through the cracks. Spotlight on you, boy, how you gonna act?
Hey, I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. I remember sleeping with my ribs touched.
Folder, you can stand firm. I'm a real one, so I ain't concerned. I'm fully built for this life. I think I earned all my stripes. I don't believe all the hype. Get back on my feet and get right. Watch you work, watch you hate, watch them lurk. Can't relate, watch you skirt. Out the mud, out the dirt, above the waters, in the murks, out the gate, on sight. Red breed, red tight, set the bar, take flight. Yeah, I been grinding since I'm young and they told me my timing was coming. I been hustling with no fun and forget all the fame, get the money. I'm out in LA where it's sunny. I been eating since I'm young and since we ain't have food in our tummy. The life we was living ain't funny, but you cannot take nothing from me. Put that on my mama, my daughter, my cousin, my brother, I'll show you. Way better than I can tell you. The type of dreams that they sell you. That's why I learned from my failures. Don't do the handouts or the favors. Told my brother I'ma get this paper. Was left behind, I'll see it later. To keep it real, you don't need to wait up. Lay it all on the line, ain't no looking back. Giving my all with no strings attached. Came from the bottom, rolls through the cracks. Spotlight on you, boy, you gon' act.
Hey, I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. My ribs touched.